William H. Carney, a courageous man. William H. Carney was born a slave on February 29, 1840 in Norfolk, Virginia. His father escaped slavery through an underground railroad system and worked hard to buy his family freedom. The family reunited in the early 1850s. Back then, African Americans couldn't go to school, so he got secretly involved in academics. William H. Carney wanted to be a minister, but then decided to be in the army. After Abraham Lincoln signed a paper to approve the recruitment of African Americans, he thought the best way to honor God and serve his country was to enlist in the war. He joined the first group of African American soldiers called the 54th Massachusetts Infantry Regiment. In the summer of 1863, the 54th Massachusetts was sent to James Island, South Carolina, where they saw its first battle. William H. Carney saw the colored surgeon, the person who holds the flag, fall down. He ran quickly and saved the flag and was shot in the leg, chest, and another in his arm. He ignored the pain and kept going. Another bullet grazed his head. Before he collapsed, he said, "Boys, the old flag never touched the ground." Because of his actions, he inspired all the other soldiers to do their best and eventually ended up winning the Battle of Fort Wagner. He put his life at risk for trying to protect the U.S. flag. On June 30, 1864, he was discharged from the army because of his wounds. William H. Carney married Susanna Carney in 1865 and had a child who was a successful music teacher. On May 23, 1900, William H. Carney received the Medal of Honor. On December 8, 1908, William H. Carney died in an elevator accident. There is a memorial in Boston, Massachusetts, honoring Colonel Robert Goldshaw and the members of the 54th Massachusetts Regiment who died in the Battle of Fort Wagner. Today, he is remembered as the first African American to receive the Medal of Honor. Every time someone asked him about his bravery, he responded, "I only did my duty."